of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Sisters and brothers, as we gather to celebrate this most sacred liturgy, we begin the fifth week in ordinary time. So we call to mind our sins, and we ask the Lord for mercy and forgiveness.
I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done or what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, when shall I arise? Then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, This is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not reach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense. But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with the stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I become weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
in the spiritual life.
We've all heard this before, so.
We want to hear.
You want to hear it?
Good answer. In the spiritual life, the great spiritual writer of St. John of the Cross, who was a Carmelite reformer, with his contemporary, St. Teresa of Avila, they reformed the Carmelites. St. John of the Cross often writes about the spiritual life, and he says that the spiritual life is highs and lows, comparable to, now he doesn't say this, because they didn't have such words back then. But the spiritual life is like a roller coaster. You know, you go up and you go down, you go up and you go down. John, St. John, says that when we're up here on the mountain, we love God. Everything is fine, right? I mean, we're in awe of God, we love Him, and so on. But then he says, when we come down from that mountain, and he calls it the valley, he also says, this is where the dark night of the soul happens, down here. His point is, when we're here, we love God. Well, what happens when we're down here? Well, a good example of here and here is Job. Job. We don't often talk about Job, but Job is a wonderful character in the Old Testament. Now, Job was blessed in the sense that he had everything. Job had everything. He had livestock. I mean, thousands of, you know, heads of cows and sheep, and I mean, just incredible wealth. He also had many, 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 many wives. He was blessed. I can't comment because I've never been married. I have no idea what it's like to be married. So, but I hear stuff. You know, so I hear less. And here's Job. He loves God. Loves God tremendously. Why wouldn't you? But one day, the devil decides that Job needs to be tested. And so he proposes a challenge to God. He says, he's faithful to you because of all the stuff that you give him. Will he be faithful if you take it all away? God loves a challenge. And so God takes it all away from him. Everything. Everything. It was so bad that Job developed sores all over his body. That's how bad he was. So he went from here, you know, great wealth, to in the valley where he had nothing. Nothing. And the devil said, now watch. He's going to rebel against you. Well, Job does the opposite, doesn't he? Job remains faithful. Even though he's at the end, or he thinks he is, he remains faithful. Faithful. He had no food, he had no housing, you know, I mean, nothing, nothing, nothing. And back then, in his day, no one, you know, there was no Catholic charities, there were no shelters, you know.
know, when if you were homeless or you were hungry, too bad, pretty much. I mean, really. Nobody would come up and feed you. Yet Job remained steadfast in his faith. Never wavered. Never wavered. And so, because of that, the devil went away and said, "Man, I'll try you again later." And God restores Job with not only what he had, he gives him even more. So now he got more wives. Let's get expensive. And so he is restored to his former self, teaching us about our own faithfulness to God. You know, when we're healthy and, you know, we have a job that does well, blah, 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 you know, God is great. But when I don't have that, God isn't so great. As I've gotten older, I wake up every morning with a pain that I didn't have the night before. Right? Did you all experience that? Oh my gosh. Where did it come from? But I've also picked up on this bad habit now that if I'm, you know, when I'm getting out of bed or I grunt. Ah. You want to do that? Ah. I'm thinking, no, I'm not going to do that. But I do it anyway. And as we age, and all of us do, we begin to, change. Our bodies change. You know, when you're 16 and 17, you're immortal. Right? We were all immortal at 16, right? Well, but then reality sets in and, ooh, boy, you know, what was once up and firm now is down in some of us. We change. Our bodies change. And yet, in spite of all of our complaints, we all know there are those who are worse off than we are. Yeah. Driving here, and I live down in Midtown, driving here in the rain, people on the street, sleeping underneath the, with the rain and all. And I'm thinking, and I complain. I have a house. And I complain about that. I have cable, and I complain about that. Because, you know, 9 million channels. There's nothing to watch. Right? Regardless of what I have or don't think I have, there's always somebody who has none. Nothing. Nothing. And the lesson that Job teaches us is that God is always faithful. And he blesses us each and every day. We may not know nor realize it, but he blesses us each and every day. It may not be as big as we think we deserve, right? But he does. He does. And Job is a great, great model for us. Model of patience. Have you noticed that as we age, we have less and less of patience? Did you notice that? Drive in Memphis. There's no patience. And I've also realized that there are more and more things that hurt me. You find that? When I go to Kroger, which is a chore because you have to have a fortune to go to Kroger, I realize I'm less and less patient with people. When you're going down the aisles, you're not the only one on the aisle. Right, you find that true?
Yeah.
Put the cart to the side so I can get through. Right? See, I'm not making this stuff up.
This is true.
Right? So now what I do, and I shouldn't do it, and I probably should confess it, I just push the cart to the side. I mean, if you're going to be that dumb, well, you know, that's what you deserve. Thoughtless. The other day, a couple days ago, I call it Kroger from hell. Guess which one? I'm Union. Right?
Yep.
Union. I call it the Kroger from hell. You call it that? I do. Starting with the parking lot. The checkout line, I do checkout. It's fine. Went all the way to the, towards the end. Well, a lady tried to cut in. Now, she was older, and I should have just, I thought, you know what? Look at all these people waiting. I'm sorry, but no. So I said, ma'am, back of the line. And of course, she got offended. Too bad. If you're handicapped, then fine. I don't have a problem. But, you know, no. I have to follow the rules. You got to follow the rules. Even the Kroger from hell. So, what is the lesson for each one of us here? That when life gets tough, and it does, always does, remember this and remember Job. And remember his faithfulness in spite of his troubles. Because no matter what, we're still better off than most. Amen?
Amen.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father of all men, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God from true God, begotten not of me, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified and consubstantial. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son.
believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And in faith, we offer our prayers to the Father.
City, our nation, and throughout the world. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For my good friend Bill Hospital, have a safe operation, and for my brother-in-law, who just had his operation, and for my cousin, of all that open heart surgery.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the unborn children in the world, Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, hear the prayers that we have placed before you. In the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives with you in the Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Saint Michael, the
archangel,
defend us from death. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Can we get a little preparation first? Is it your parish?
Blessed are you, O Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God
forever. Blessed are you, O Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit and touch of heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, O Lord God. And Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me of all my sins. And now, sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice.
O Lord our God, who once established these sacred rites to sustain us in our weakness, grant we pray that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator. He has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you. He is the truth that sets us free. He is the life that fills us with gladness. And through your Son, you gather men and women whom you have made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross, and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our bishop, and all the clergy. And remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with St. Augustine, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who were pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Welcome each other with sight and peace.
Thank you.
young boy was eating fish, and he started choking on the bone of the fish. And his mother asked for the intercession of St. Blaise for her son, and the fish bone dislodged. And so Blaise became the patron of throats. We use candles because we celebrate Sunday was a feast of Candlemas Day. And Candlemas Day used to be very, very important in the days when all the churches had real candles. You know, they had to be beeswax. Well, now most churches have plastic bulbs. So Candlemas Day doesn't have the same importance, but churches still do bless candles on Candlemas Day. And at one time, the two candles were lit. Yeah. So when you came up for the blessing, the candles were lit on either side of your ears. And then something happened. Hairspray. Hairspray came into me, and I believe it was Aquanet. I don't know if you remember. And of course, flame, hairspray don't go well together. So the church decides maybe we shouldn't light the candles. So thank goodness we don't do that anymore. So after Mass, I will do that for you. And let us pray. Having fed, O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that in one in Christ we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for some announcements.
We are in need of sacristans. If you are able and willing to volunteer, please call the church office with your contact information. Counters are needed on Sunday. Call the church office if you are able to volunteer. Don't forget to see one of the salt members to purchase your ticket for the Mardi Gras, which will be held on February 10th. The 2024 Faithfield Hearts Gala is fast approaching. If you have not purchased your tickets, please do so today. This fundraising initiative is in support of St. Augustine Church. Tickets will not be sold at the door, so stop procrastinating. Don't sit on the sidelines and hear about it from someone else. Buy your tickets today. Additional announcements from the pastor. Due to the snowstorm and freezing temperatures, we had one weekend where our collection was only a little over $2,000. Even through ice storms and snow, the parish still needs your support and contributions. We had a shortfall of $9,000 last month. Please remember the parish is asking you to prayerfully consider a 13% increase in giving for your weekly donation. Please give generously to our 21st Century Fund this week to support our continued ongoing repairs for our HVAC system. Currently, we have $265,000 in the 21st Century Fund. Remember, $61,000 is earmarked for our air conditioning from the insurance company. Our Faithfield Hearts Lifetime Achievement Award Gala is quickly approaching. Please make an ad and support with an additional gift. Simply click on support and you can create an ad and make a donation. Black History Month, Faithfield Hearts Mass. Saturday, February 24th, Bishop Terry Stye, SBD, will be our come to this Mass and support Bishop Stott. We are asking the 11 a.m. choir to sing at this Mass. Remembering the ancestors, as we did early in my arrival in the parish on Sunday, February 11th, we will remember our ancestors with the libation of water pouring. This will take place during our Mass after the homily, just before the profession of faith. This is done to remember those who have died. The earth is sacred because it is where the remains of our ancestors are placed. This has been a practice as a part of our African-American culture, tradition, within the liturgy, just as it in other cultural expressions have been added to the Mass. An example, the lasso used in Spanish wedding ceremonies, the jumping of the broom in African-American weddings, and the breaking of the glass, and mazel tov in marriages with Jewish spouses in a marriage. We will continue to do this occasionally as we remember our ancestors who have gone before us. As you call out a name, I will repeat the name and pour the water. Thank you, Father Stephan. Anthony?
Here.
All right, come on.
Good afternoon, St. Augustine family.
Good afternoon.
My name is Anthony Thompson. I come to you today on behalf of the Men of St. Augustine Men's Club. And I would like to remind some of our brothers and inform others that by virtue of your consistent presence at St. Augustine, you're naturalized as a member of the Men's Club. So you're automatically in the Men's Club. There's no special initiation, no application fee. Just show up, okay? And we value the engagement and contributions of each and every one, okay? And we're proud and excited to announce that after a lengthy hiatus imposed by the pandemic of 2020, we are restarting our Men's Month celebration, okay? We'll begin with the men's prayer breakfast Saturday, March 2nd at 9 a.m. All men are invited. There's no admission fee or anything. Just be there. And then Sunday, March 10th, we will present our acclaimed Men Who Cook, 3 o'clock p.m., okay? And so we'll dust off your recipe, get those pots and pans banging, okay? And bring your best shot, okay? It's not a competition. It's a collaboration and a celebration. Okay? So, you know, you don't have to worry about being judged. And Men's Month will then culminate Sunday, March 17th at 3 p.m. with our Men's Day program. We're expecting it to be one of the best we've ever done. Okay? In the coming weeks, there will be Men's Club representatives available in the narthex after each Mass to collect Men's Month assessments. That there will be $100. Don't have to do it all at once. And we did have someone ask why it was so low. We want everyone to be able to participate. And if you think it's not enough, we always welcome you. Don't turn it down. Okay? We're not going to send that $3,000 check back, okay? And so we'll also have a sign-up sheet for Men Who Cook participants and Men's Choir recruitment. And on that note, we'll have announcements to recruit choir members for the Men's Choir for Men's Day. There will be cajoling. There will be encouragement. There will be arm twisting. Okay? You don't have to. We don't need Dottie McClurkin, Ty Tribbett, you know, or Smokey Norfolk, anyone. We need your voice. Okay? And don't you decide whether you can do it or not. Come to the rehearsal and let us tell me what you can do. I see between my voice and Wayne's voice and Terry's voice, you know, we might make one decent voice. Yeah. You know, so let's try that, okay? And we look forward to unprecedented for to unprecedented engagement and participation for unprecedented success for our men's month of 2024 as we return to our mission. So dust off those recipes, get the banging, and warm up those vocal cords, and be sure to have your throat blessed so we can be ready for it. Okay? Thank you.
Session of singing.